Okay, our last speaker this morning is Ilya Lopatin from the Steklov Mathematical Institute.
Thank you very much, dear organizers. I express my... Okay. Okay. I express my gratitude to the program committee for the kind invitation to give a talk today. So, first of all, I would like to recall the definition of the Hermite Padé polynomials of the both type, despite I think this definition was given in many previous talks today. So, for the vector of functions having zero at infinity of a given order and multi-index n, the Hermite Padé polynomials of type 1 and type 2 are defined as follows. And in fact, it gives some linear system of linear equations of the coefficients on these polynomials, which is always solvable, but the solution in general case is not unique. Today, I would like to talk about a very restricted part of the general set of problems via Hermite Padé polynomials, about the estimation of the weakest asymptotics of these polynomials. So, for an arbitrary polynomial with complex coefficients with degree at most n, we define the counting measure as follows: the sum of delta masses centered at the zeros of the polynomial counted with respect of the multiplicities. And we would like to investigate the weak star limit of the counting measures of the Hermite Padé polynomials for a considerably wide class of functions. So, for example, the class as A sigma, which is defined as the class of functions which can be analytically continued over any path in a complex line, in a complex plane, except some finite set, and such that at least one point of the set is a branch point on F. But, of course, this problem is too wide, and one of the opportunities to consider the restricted classes of functions, and the most known and investigated systems are Angelescu system and Nikishin system. So, because the definitions was given today in a lot of talks, I would omit this now and speak a bit about the known results. So, the for Nikishin, for Angelescu system, Gonchar and Rachmanov in 1981 discovered the vector potential equilibrium method of estimating of the weak asymptotics and the convergence conditions for Hermite Padé of type 2 for an Angelescu system. And 5 years later, Nikishin used this equilibrium method, equilibrium vector potential method, to estimate the weak asymptotics of Hermite Padé polynomials of type 1 for a system which is now known as Nikishin system. And these two systems were generalized in the work of Gonchar, Rachmanov, and Sorokin, as they considered a system of Markov functions generated by the graph, by graphs, which was deeply generalized by Aptekarev and Lesov in for 13 years later. And I will focus on the result of Aptekarev and Lesov because it coincides with mine in many cases. But the main thing now is that all these works deal with the vector equilibrium problem for the for estimating the weak asymptotics of Hermite Padé polynomials. And in 1987, Gonchar and Rachmanov proposed the scalar potential problem method, which works with scalar potential with some external harmonic field. And in this case, it was empirically estimated that the zeros of the corresponding Hermite Padé polynomials are attracted to some contour which is situated, which is defined as a member of some class of contours, and now it is known as a Stahl compact. So, Sergei Suetin from Stiklov Institute proposed the new approach to the estimation of the Hermite Padé polynomial for an Ekishan system of type 2 for a model pair of functions. Here it is the definition. The measure sigma 2 is some measure which is supported in a finite union of compact sets in the real line disjoint from the segment minus 1, 1, which as usual has almost positive Radon-Nikodym derivative with respect to the Lebesgue measure on it. And as sigma 1, we take the following measure. And as in general construction of the Nikishian system, we define the functions f1 and f2 as the Cauchy-Stieltjes transforms of measure mu1 and mu2. So here is the explicit view of function f1 and f2. In so it is the our consideration. We want to estimate the asymptotics, the weak asymptotics of the polynomial Q and 2. And Sergei introduced the following potential with this kernel. It's a bit mistake, so need to put square here. With the following external harmonic field. And in his paper in 2018, he proved that in the class of probability measures supported on the compact set F, there exists a unique measure which minimizes the corresponding energy functional, and this measure is characterized by the well-known equilibrium conditions. And this measure is the weak star limit of the counting measure of the polynomial Q and 2. Now we know that it is the equilibrium potential problem with exterior harmonic field on the Riemann sphere, and via Zhukovsky transform we can introduce the global coordinate and consider this in fact the planar scalar potential problem. And now I would like to consider slightly wider class of functions which gives us an opportunity to construct a scalar potential problem really on a real surface of positive genus. So the definition is quite the same, but now the measure sigma 2 is the same, the measure sigma 2 is the same, and the measure sigma 1 is defined in the following way. And as in the general definition and in the previous case, consider the Cauchy-Stieltjes transform of these measures and obtain the explicit view of functions for which we are going to estimate the asymptotics of Hermite Padé. Now I would focus on some technical moments. The same consideration, and now I should mention some facts about the analysis on the Riemann surface I need. So this is the full description, but the key point is that we consider the Riemann surface S of the Riemann of the function double where from Z, which is in fact a hyperelliptic Riemann surface of genus G, which is glued over components of the support of the first measure sigma 1. And so we the main notation is this, that we should mention that G0 and G1 is the set situated on the first or the zero sheet of the Riemann surface. And I will need some facts about the calculating the basis of the holomorphic differentials on the Riemann surface. And the if we take the cycles LG, which correspond to the to EGs, and complete it with standard in a standard way to the basis of the first homology group of the Riemann surface, I can define a normalized basis of the space of a holomorphic abelian differentials. I will use it to recover a meromorphic function on a Riemann surface in explicit view. Another thing that I need will be the meromorphic differential of the third kind, which is holomorphic in any point, at any point of S, except two points where it has simple poles with residues minus 1 and plus 1 respectively. Now a few words how to construct such a differential, and I will need the technique of the analysis on the Riemann surfaces introduced by Evgeny Chirka in 2018. So we consider the set, we consider the solution of this equation written in Durham currents on S. It is a generalized Laplace-Beltrami equation, and taking here some measure, we can consider it as a deep modification of a classical potential methods on the complex plane. Now I need the generalized Laplacians of the of the bipolar charges. Of the bipolar charges. So if I take two distinct points on S, the bipolar green function according to Chirka is the generalized Laplacian, is defined as following the equation, and the generalized Laplacian of G is this bipolar charge. And the key point is that we can consider it as a meromorphic differential of the third kind, which we will use to recover an explicit view of the function of a meromorphic function on the Riemann sphere. So, and now all is ready to formulate the main result. Here is the potential on the full Riemann surface, which with respect to this kernel, and the exterior harmonic field is defined as a logarithm the modulus of the multivariate function, which maps our surface conformally onto the Riemann sphere. It is a single-valued model, and so the function is defined correctly. And here is the corresponding energy functional, and the result, the statement of the result is quite similar to the statement of the theorem of Swetin. So if we denote the as M0F, the class of measures, probability measures supported on the copy of F line on the zero sheet of the surface S, we can obtain the solution of the following minimization problem, and it will be the weak star limit of the counting measures of polynomials Q and 2 and Q and 1. So now a few words about the proof, just a bit. A few words about the technique of the recovering of a meromorphic function by its divisor. So if I have a divisor D on a Riemann surface S, according to Abel's theorem, it is a divisor of, really a divisor of some meromorphic function F on S. If there is some one chain such that the divisor is its boundary and an integral over any holomorphic form on it is zero. So it gives me an opportunity to write the necessary condition of the theorem as a system of equations which can be used to define the points SG, the Jacobi inversion problem. And here it is the explicit view of a general function on meromorphic function on Riemann surfaces with the prescribed divisor. So, and now a few steps of the proof, how what we are doing in fact. From this representation, we can obtain the following orthogonality condition of the conditions of the polynomial Qn2, where Qm1 and Qm2 are an arbitrary polynomials, degree at most m1, and h are the function of the second kind of the classical Hermite Padé approximants of the function F2. And now the main idea is to consider this weight as a function written on the sheet zero of the Riemann surface S, and to recover the explicit view of this function to obtain the orthogonality conditions written on the full surface S. So here is the key points. We find the divisor of M and Z, define the positions of free zeros whereas the Jacobi inversion solution of the Jacobi inversion problem, and apply the prescribed technique of the recovering of a function of a Riemann surface. So here it is, the explicit view of the weight. And now we can apply the Gonchar-Rachmanov's method, Gonchar-Rachmanov theorem, which is now is known as Rachmanov's two-point method, to estimate the asymptotics of a polynomial Qn, Qn2. I will omit further technique moments and said a few words about how to prove the uniqueness of the theorem and the uniqueness of this measure lambda, the minimizing measure. It's due to the results of Chirka about the generalized symmetric kernel on a Riemann surface. He proved that it is positive on neutral charges, and it is widely known via Gonchar-Rachmanov result that it is sufficient to prove the uniqueness of minimizing measure for, via of course some technical moments, for our kernel. So we estimated the asymptotics of Qn2 and proved that it coincides with the solution of the potential problem on a Riemann surface of positive genus. So, and now I will omit the estimation of asymptotics of Qn1 and say a bit about the connections with the Aptekarev-Lissov result. So they considered the functions, Markov functions generated by a special graph. And in fact, here is the construction of the graph which gives us the function of our consideration. And Aptekarev-Lissov proved the result for polynomials of type 2. And in fact, very more general result, but it follows from the result, it follows the weak asymptotics of type 2 for this pair of functions. And two moments. Suetin proved that for his consideration for the function f1 and f2 of first form, the vector equilibrium problem and scalar equilibrium problem, are equivalent. And Now, probably these two results is a very good framework to understand a pattern of framework to understand the real connection with the vector and the scalar equilibrium problem. And of course, we hope that the main problem now is that in optical philosophy and in Nikishian considerations, the support of measure sigmas in the construction of the Nikishian systems are always situated on the real line. And Cirka's kernel is extremely flexible. And we hope that this technique will give us an opportunity to estimate the asymptotics for a real complex weight. So, as I understand, my time is over. So, thank you for your attention.
Thank you. Questions? Arne, go ahead.
Hello, I have a question. Is there an issue about finding a curve with the S property on the Riemann surface? Did you have that property? Did that come up in your work?
Yeah, it's a main problem we are thinking now about. It's a key point to estimate them, yeah. I don't know how it's really difficult or not difficult now, but it's a very good question. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you for the nice talk.
I think it's again a problem of finding trajectories of certain quadratic differentials, right?
Yeah.
Okay, some more remarks or questions? Nobody online? Well, let's thank Ilya again.